specifically from the House floor in Congress. Your representative here in Colorado, Jared Polis, did that. Ed Perlmutter helped us with fighting on the HEA drug provision that has prevented over 200,000 kids from getting students from getting financial aid because of simply smoking a joint. You have Doug Linkhart, who's running for mayor, who's taken some tough votes on this issue, but he stood strong. Now, I got to tell you, very quickly to wrap up, we've got some challenges ahead.
You know, we had an election where we lost a ballot measure in California, but like I say, we're not discouraged. Now, we also, our side, lost some friends at the top in Congress, right? And the Republican Congress is probably going to be Republican for the next 10 years or so because the Republicans won something like 700 state legislative seats. They'll get to draw the boundaries again. But the point is, the good news here is that 43 of the 63 Democrats who lost, 70% of them, were useless blue dog Democrats who always voted against medical marijuana. So good riddance, guys. We're glad to see you go. Very quickly. One minute. Very quickly, we're also facing some fights at the national level. We're going to have another Coburn Amendment, you could probably expect. Senator Coburn from Oklahoma, one of the most conservative senators in the country, probably going to try to wipe out medical marijuana laws. He's obsessed with this. And so I would just ask you to consider that when you know this fight comes up, to honor Senator Coburn's obsession with our medical marijuana laws, look up an Urban Dictionary. Try to help me out, spread the word. That every time, to honor Senator Coburn's obsession, I think that every time we refer to two people smoking a joint together, we call it a Coburn. Okay, thank you so much for having me. Register to vote, get out and vote, sign up on our website, ssdp.org. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Eric. Our next speaker is, if you spend any time in California and toured any of the dispensaries, this next speaker is someone you must know or know about and probably met, because he has set the standard for dispensaries in the state of California. It's, I think, the largest, it's the most modern, it's the first one I went to where you didn't feel like you were doing something down and dirty. I felt like I was a Department of Motor Vehicles office or something. It's clean, it's modern, and it's the new image that we all need to adopt. Please welcome Stephen DeAngelo, the founder and head of Harborside Health Center in Oakland.
Thanks, Keith, for that kind introduction. I don't know that I would choose the DMV analogy, but yes, all the rest is very much true. So Colorado, congratulations, number 15, well done. Give yourselves a hand. I've been a cannabis activist since I was 13 years old, and it's been hugely exciting to me to watch the progress that we've made since 1996 as one state after another has enacted legalization of medical cannabis. I think Colorado was particularly exciting for me to see how rapidly the cannabis industry took root here and grew and expanded and became regulated and became a legitimate and responsible part of society here. It's without question the most rapid emergence of a medical cannabis community that we've seen in the history of the movement. So again, well done for doing that.